Hello students, welcome to online classes for the first year students of Kakatiya Graduate Junior College Narsambet. Now today the topic is, so in this mathematics B paper, the one of the first topic is locus. Of course the previous classes coordinates, this is an introduction to the geometry, coordinate geometry. Now this is the main topic is the locus. So it is the class number 4. Now this is a locus, means the set of all the points moving in a plane such that which satisfies the well-defined mathematical condition. Yes, in this, so the set of all the points is moving in a plane such that which satisfies the well-defined mathematical condition. Now students, we observe this. Yeah, this is the coordinate point x, y. Yes, it is a variable coordinate point. Next, and another one is x1, y1. Yes, students, this is the fixed coordinate point. And all these set of moving points we consider as x, y. X, y means it is the set of all the moving points. So, in this plane. Now, for example, here in this plane. Yes, in this plane, yeah, this is the locus point. Locus point means the set of all the moving points. Yes, the set of all the moving points we consider as a x, y. So, yeah, this point is moving in a place such that it is, so, 3 units distance from the, 3 units distance from the point 4, 3. Yes, students, here, the locus condition, that means the suitable mathematical condition. Here PA is equal to 3. Yes, this is the locus condition. Now, PA is equal to 3. Here already we know this PA means the distance between P and A. Students, we know this, the distance between the two fixed points. Here under root of x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. Yeah, this is the formula for finding the distance between the two fixed points. Yes, dear students, here PA means under root of distance between P and A is given by x minus 4 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to 3. Yes, students, squaring on both sides. Here under root of x minus 4 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square, here whole square is equal to 3 square. For the square root cancel, to expand this, x minus 4 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to 3 square is equal to 9. To expand this, x minus 4 whole square as a minus b whole square, here also a minus b whole square. Students, we know this a minus b whole square expansion, a square minus 2ab plus b square, and similarly a plus b whole square expansion, here a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now by using these expansions here, to expand this x minus 4 whole square, yes, x square minus, here in this 4 to 8x plus 4 square is equal to 16, and similarly here y square minus 6y plus 9 is equal to 9. On both sides, both 9s are cancelled. Write this equation in order of the, here x square plus y square minus 8x minus 6y plus 16 is equal to 0. Yes, this is the locus equation of P such that the PA is equal to 3. So students, in this topic, here we should find out the locus equation of the point. So with the help of the given locus condition. Here in this, locus means the set of all the moving points, so moving in a plane such that which satisfies the well-defined mathematical condition. Here for taking one of the example here, the set of all the moving points, so moving in a plane such that, so which are 3 units distance from the fixed point 4, 3, then we have to find out the locus of P. Yes, here for getting the locus equation of the point P of x, y, here initially we should take the locus condition. Here in this locus condition is, PA is equal to 3. Yes, PA means what? The distance between the moving point and the fixed point. Already we know this, the distance between the two points. Here root of x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. Here we applying this formula in between A and B, that is under root of x minus 4 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to 3. Here squaring on both sides, and after that x minus 4 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to 9. To expand this x minus 4 whole square as x square minus 8x plus 16, y minus 3 whole square as y square minus 6y plus 9 is equal to 3 square is also 9. Both lines are cancelled. Then here we can write, we have to write these terms in orderly. X square plus y square minus 8x minus 6y plus 16 is equal to 0. Here this equation is represents, of course it is a circle. Now the fixed point is called the center and the constant distance is called the radius. Okay, this is the locus equation of the point P such that PA is equal to 3. And students, taking another example in this. Okay, students. So in this topic locus, this is the second example. Now the question is, find the locus equation of a point P. Okay, such that PA is equal to 2 of PB, where the given two fixed points here, A is equal to 1 comma 2 and B is equal to 3 comma 4. Yes, students. Here in a plane, here we consider the locus point P is equal to x comma y. And these are the given points, A is equal to 1 comma 2 and B is equal to 3 comma 4. Now the given condition here, PA is equal to 2 of PB, both distances, one of the distance PA is twice the distance, so between PA and B. For getting this locus equation here, so now the locus point here, the locus point coordinates here P of x comma y. Yes. Given points, so the given points, students, given points are A is equals to 1 comma 2 and B is equals to 3 comma 4. Locus condition here, the locus condition. Here already given that the locus condition is, it is nothing but a mathematical condition. So then PA is equals to 2 of PB. Yes, so squaring on both sides. Here PA whole square is equals to the square of here 4 and PB whole square. Yes, PA square, the square of the distance between P and A, here is given by the distance formula. Here for the square, square root cancel. Here PA square is x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to 4 of PB square is equals to x minus 3 whole square plus y minus 4 whole square. Yes, students, to expand this, x minus 1 whole square here, x square minus 2x plus 1, here y minus 2 whole square, y square minus 4y plus 4. To expand this as a minus b whole square, here y minus 2 whole square, y square minus 4y plus 4 is equals to 4 of, to expand this also, x square minus 6x plus 9, okay, x minus 3 whole square, like a minus b whole square, and plus y minus 4 whole square here, y square minus 8y plus 16. Yes, now students, write all these LHS items in orderly, taking in order x square plus y square minus 2x, yes, minus 4y, 1 plus 4 here, 5. Here in this, each and every term we must multiply with 4, that means here 4x square, here plus 4y square, yes, 6, 4 ja, 24, 24x, okay, and 8, 4 ja, 32, minus 32y, and constants here, 16 plus 9, 25, 25, 4 ja, 25, 4 ja here, 100. Here all these terms we kept into the LHS side. Yes, RHS side. Here these terms we kept into the RHS side. This 0 is equals to here 4x square plus 4y square minus 24x minus 32y plus 100. And these terms we kept into another side. This Yeah, it's changing its sides. Plus changes to minus, minus changes to plus. Yeah, these are changes as minus x square, minus y square, plus 2x, plus 4y, plus 4y, minus 5, minus 5. Yes, students, here we simplify this. 4x square minus x square, that means here 3x square. 4y square minus y square plus 3y square. And minus 24x plus 2x minus 22x. Yes. Minus 32y plus 4y minus 28. Minus 28y. Yes. And a constant here 100 minus 5. So plus 95. Yes, students, this is the equation of locus of P, such that the condition for this condition is PA is equal to 2 of PB. Here in this topic, yes, students, so we getting the locus equation of P with the help of the given locus condition. Here in this, to expand this, so to simplify the to apply the locus condition and simplify this so relations in terms of the variables, then we will get in the locus equation in terms of x and y.